How to use Cisco Webex Cloud Meeting for Android. This tutorial will present how to install the app, how to join a meeting, how to create an account, how to create a meeting, and how to schedule a meeting. The last part of the video, we will talk how to share screen on Webex Meeting for Android. Cisco Webex Meetings delivers over 6 billion meetings per month, offering industry-leading video and audio conferencing with sharing, chat, and more. Experience why more people use Webex Meetings than all other meetings vendors combined. Let's see how to install Cisco Webex Meetings on Android. First, we need to go to Google Play. So open Google Play. On the search above, write Cisco Webex. Now, tap on search. After you have found the app, just tap on install and wait. You have now installed Cisco Webex Meetings on your Android device. After the install is complete, just tap on open. Now, tap on accept to open the app. Tap OK. Here, tap allow to all 5 dialogs. Now let's see how to join a meeting on Webex Cloud Meeting for Android. If you wish to enter into a meeting, you will need to have the ID of the session and also, if needed, a password. Find this info from the host. Now, tap on Join Meeting. Here, write the ID of the meeting. Please note that you can also receive a link from the host. If you have the link, you will no longer need the ID of the meeting and you will enter directly at the meeting. Tap Join. On this page, you can activate your microphone or camera. If the buttons are red, then it means the microphone and the camera are off. Tap on Join. The meeting is starting. Now, at the meeting, you will be able to mute or unmute yourself from the bottom. Also, you will be able to start the webcam or not. If you tap on the 3 dots from the menu, you will get to a bigger list. Switch speakers, mic, is essential. If you do not hear well or you wish not to hold the phone near your ear, you can switch the audio to speakers. Also, you will be able to enter the chat. You will find here the option to share content. You can share files and screen share. Pooling does not work on Android phones. Also here, you can set up so the meeting is only audio without any video. If you wish to find more about the meeting, tap on info. But how can we create an account for Webex Cloud Meeting app for Android? Please note, you do not need to create an account if you only join the meeting. You can use it as a guest user as well. You can create an account when you wish to host meetings or you use the app quite often. So first, go to the app. On this page, tap on Sign Up link. You will be redirected to a web page where you can create your account. Write your email and tap Sign Up. Select your country and write your first name and last name. Tap Continue. You have received an email so you can set up your password. Let's go to our email app. I will go to Gmail. Tap on the link Create a password. Write the password and then confirm the password. Tap Continue. Now your account is created. tap on Launch Installed App. Tap Allow. Now write your email and tap Next. Select a site, what you want, it does not matter. Write your password. You are now logged in with your account on the app. You can easily change your picture on the app. Tap on the image. Here, tap again on the picture. You can take a picture or simply upload one. I will upload an old photo. Now let's find the picture and tap on it. You can edit your picture here so you can look awesome. After you have finished, just tap Use Photo. Now, you can start creating meeting and use the account for your benefit. Now, we will see how we can create a meeting on the Webex app for Android. For you to start a simple meeting, just tap on the Start Meeting button. On this page, you can activate your microphone or camera. If the buttons are red, then it means the microphone and camera are off. Tap on Start. The meeting is starting. From the start, I got to this page. This page offers you excellent info. One of the essential info is the meeting number. If you wish to allow others to get into your meeting, just give them this ID. They will be able to join very quickly. Let's tap on the three dots. Here, we have also some attractive options. Lock room will not allow other persons to enter into the meeting. Switch speaker mic is also essential. If you do not hear well, or you wish not to hold your phone near your ear, you can enable this. You will find here the option to share content. You will be able to share files and screen share. Also, we have chat option. Pulling does not work on Android phones. Also, here, you can set up so the meeting is only audio, without any video. If you wish to find more about this meeting, tap on Info. On this page, you will get also an important information for the person that cannot get into the meeting by the app. They can also call a phone number and write an access code, and they will enter into the session. Also, these call-in numbers are available in multiple countries. Tap on the global call-in numbers to see your local country number. You can share the room join link by tapping the share button from the top. Let's select messages and send a message with this link. You can use any app for this. Now, let's close this. Let's tap on the participants button from the top. Here, you will see a full list of participants. Now, tap Invite button from the bottom. Here, you will be able to send reminders if you invite somebody to the meeting or simply invite by email. Let's tap on Invite by email. Write the email and tap Send. You can also write multiple emails and then tap Send. Your email has been sent. Now, let's see how it looks when somebody joins the meeting. Now you see the person has appeared on the screen. Also, there are other possibilities when somebody joins the meeting. Let me show you. It is possible to receive also a notice like this, that a person enters into the lobby. For this person to enter into the meeting, you will need to tap the participant button. Tap on the orange notice. If you wish to admit that person to enter into the meeting, just tap Select All and Admit. If you keep your finger on a username, also you will get a menu. You will have the possibility to make him the presenter. This means he will be able to share screen and talk. You can make him the host and allow the same administrative access. If you wish to remove it from the meeting, just tap on Expel. Also, on this button, you can unmute all participants if you wish to do this action. Now, you have started a meeting. But what if you wish to create a schedule meeting? How do we do that? So, let's start scheduling a meeting on Webex app. If you are on this page, just swipe from left to right. Here, you will see on the top a plus button. Tap on that. Now, we started the process of scheduling the meeting. On top, you can give a name for your meeting. You can set up a password. If you wish to see the current password, just check the Show Password checkbox. You can send invites to the other persons. You can enter their email here. Let's test one. You can write as many emails as you want. Select the exact time of the meeting here. Set up the duration of the meeting. Now, let's tap on Schedule from the top. You see that a new meeting has appeared on my schedule. I have received an email from Webex meeting regarding the invitations I just sent. Tap on the meeting. You will see here the info about the meeting. Also, on Audio tab, you will get the info that you need to send to a person who joins by phone. If you tap on Global Call-in Numbers, you can get a local number from your country. If you forgot somebody to invite, you could send more invites if you tap on the button with a profile plus. And you have the share button here, so you can use any app to share the link. If you wish to start the meeting, tap on Start. Now, all that you do is the same as you normally use on a meeting. I already explained all features on how to create a meeting part. In the last part of the video, we will talk about how to share screen on Webex Meeting for Android. Let's see how to use the screen share on Webex Meeting. You need to be in a meeting and also have permission from the host to share the screen. If you do not have this, you might not be able to share the screen, depending on how the host set up the meeting. Tap on the three dots from the bottom. We have here multiple options: to share a whiteboard, share screen, files from different cloud providers, and also a photo. Let's test now a bit the sharing for whiteboard. Let's talk about the option we have. The first option we have on this bar is the pen. The pen will allow you to draw, write, or make anything on your screen as you usually do with a pen on a piece of paper. Also, you can change the color on this option. The second option is the text option. You can simply add the text to your whiteboard. The third option is erase. Simply tap this option and then tap on one of the modifications you did, and that will be deleted. The fourth option is point. This option will set a pointer on the screen that will allow you, the person who follows you, to pay attention to this part. One of the vital features that you need to know is hidden on the More button. Tap on the three dots. Here you have option Let only the presenter annotate. If you enable this option, other person will not be able to make anything on the whiteboard. This is useful if you are a teacher and you do not wish the kids to write on the whiteboard. If you wish to save your drawings, there is the possibility of saving on this button as well. After you have finished and you wish to close the whiteboard, tap on the back arrow from the top. Let's try to share a photo on the screen share. So select photo. Find and select the photo you wish to share. On the photo sharing, you will also be able to edit the page as the whiteboard. Tap on the first button from the top. Now you see you have the same option as the whiteboard. You can use it the same. To get back to the previous menu, tap on the arrow from the top. The second option is the rotate feature. If the picture is not correctly added, just rotate it to look okay for you and your participants. Now, tap on Stop Sharing. Let's try now Screen Sharing. Just tap on the Screen Sharing. You might get a notice about allowing the app to appear on the top. If so, tap on Settings and enable the app to appear on top. Let's see how this looks on somebody else's screen. I am looking at my PC and it looks and moves quite well. You can also do some excellent stuff here. Tap on the Cisco icon and select Annotation. You have the same bar with option that we explained. Nice, we can even paint on our phone. After we have finished sharing, just tap on the Cisco logo and tap Stop Sharing. Please note that sound from your phone, like playing a video on YouTube, might not work. Participants will see the screen but will not hear the sound. For sharing data with audio, I always suggest using a laptop or PC with Windows or Mac. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them on the comments area below.